Juice of the Oats Oatmeal Stout from Oxus Brewing in Winnipeg. It's a dark ale with coffee and chocolate aromas, creamy smooth body, and a pretty good head. Comes from the usage of oats in the mash. That is a very nice, once again. I knew that going in. I've had this one before, and I like it. And these guys actually, very recently, have just opened a tap room at their brewery. Sampling or tasting room. Basically a wee pub right at the brewery. Very handy. And I think it's conveniently located, too, for my daily activities, which is pretty cool. Anyway, beer is nice, but today I've got this little video projector. Isn't that cute? What do we got for size here? Looks like it's about 21 centimeters that way by about 18 that way. Fits in the palm of your hand. So I remember probably about 10-ish years ago, maybe longer, when these things first came out, I was intrigued that they could actually get a video projector into a package that size and it would actually do anything and be useful. But of course at the time when they first came out, they were horrendously expensive and kind of a novelty, so I picked this one up at a thrift store for like under $5 with the power supply, which is good because it's a kind of an oddball power supply. It's got a slightly different connector than most of the typical stuff that we deal with. There it is beside the connector that we most commonly use in Arduino tinkering world. But it's still 12 volts and you can still get that connector. It's just more convenient that it came with the thing. But let's take a look around the back. We obviously have the DC in. There's also a 5 volt 2 amp USB, so I could have powered it off that as well. What is that little door? I don't know what that little door is. We'll worry about that later. It's a little switch to go from either plug-in power or looks like a battery. Over on this side, we have an HDMI input, an analog AV input. We have a headphone output, a USB input. On the front, we have an infrared receiver for remote control, which didn't come with the thing. And I've been playing with this thing a little bit, and none of the remote controls that I have around here, and that's quite a few of them, none of them will talk to this thing. So we can just use it through the buttons on the top. It's a little less convenient, but whatever. And then there's a micro SD card slot on the front. So various different ways to get video into this thing. I think I'm going to use USB just because it's less dicking around, just for today's experiments. But I have tried the other ones and they do work. Just I don't have an HDMI source conveniently located to here, and I don't have, I'm sure I've got something that that has analog AV, but again, it's not conveniently located to my workshop, but it does work, and the SD card works too. So anyway, let me clean this crap out of the way and get it set up. Oh yeah, it's got a little tripod mount on the bottom, so I'll park it on this thing. A little rubbery lens cover, manual focus adjustment, which basically you adjust the focus to accommodate the distance that you got this, your projection screen away from this thing, your projection surface. And under here is a battery connector. I assume that's going to be some variant of a rechargeable battery. 12 volts, 12.3 volts, okay. So that's going to be some kind of a little 12 volt pack. Nothing like that kicking around here. We will just ignore it for now. Okay, so there's the test setup that I've got right now. That is what, 30 inches or about 760 millimeters thereabouts. So that's the setup that we're going to be using right now. I've got my bench lights turned off, and for the rest of this, for a while, I think I'm going to turn off actually even the room lights. Some of them anyways. Okay, so there's another angle of it. So at that distance, we get a picture of 10 inches, which is 25 centimeters by 17 inches, which is about 44 or so centimeters. That's not too bad, I guess. I mean, there's only one light bulb in the room, a 60 watt equivalent, and it's way back over there, so it's not really shining on this. But if I zoom fully into this thing, well, maybe not fully, but you can see it is kind of pixely. Let me grab my USB here and put something up on the screen. Okay, so that's about as in focus as I can get the thing. And I figured these would be a reasonable selection of still images to use. The color is not bad on it. I've got this room fairly darkened, but a picture like of that size, yeah, it's about the size. It's a little bit smaller than the standard old school CRT television. That would be the equivalent of a 20 inch CRT television that we're seeing there. And it's okay in a dimly lit room, I guess, but those pixels are freaking huge. So there's maximum zoom in, and I'm not sure if you can see that or not, but the pixels are pretty damn close to 1 millimeter at that distance. That's horrendous. So, I mean, it's better than nothing, I guess, if you're in a tent or something. It'd probably work okay. I wouldn't want to go too much further, and actually the focus is almost as far back as it'll go right now. I think I could probably get another like half meter or something out of that before I wouldn't be able to focus anymore. So that's interesting. Let's just throw some video on just for the fun of it. In a dimly lit room, I guess that would be okay. That's not too bad, but again, those pixels are huge. They're like a millimeter-ish each, so it is what it is. If you go much bigger, it's going to look really chunky. But, I don't know. People were satisfied with 20-inch TVs for decades, right? So apparently, these things came out in 2003. Wow, that's further back than I thought. But yeah, handheld or pocket projectors seemed to be all the rage for a while. Although most of them turned out to have been kind of crappy. They're not very bright, and they have like VGA chipsets and stuff like that. So they're not, most of them aren't all that awesome. You can still buy them though on eBay for fairly cheap. Or if you want to buy them new, this one and this one look almost identical to the one that I've got here. Just a left for right mirror image, but totally hell. And these ones all claim to be 1080. And the ones on eBay claim to be 1080 as well. They take VGA or HDMI or whatever in. But when you scroll down to the actual specs, input resolution 1080p max, cool. Output resolutions 320 by 180. Wah, wah, wah. So, let's pull this thing off. Even that tripod thread feels cheap. I can only get in there by a couple of threads. You should be able to get like that deep into there. But I can only get about halfway in, so it's not all that stable. This power supply is good for an amp and a half. So, that's definitely something, if nothing else. I don't know, I may find uses for this thing. I'm not sure. What do we have? We got four itty bitty little screws in there. I'm going to guess that they're Phillips. Did I say four screws? I meant to say five. So what do we have in here? There's the battery wire. Got a couple of wires soldered on that are marked LED. Got a couple of wires going over to a little speaker. And I could just barely hear that fire crackling from the fireplace video, but just barely. And then there's a little plug with some wires, and then we have a flat flex connector down here, which presumably is going off to the LCD or light engine or whatever it is that makes the pixels happen. So let's pop these connectors off. flat flex, just open it up. And then this board should lift off after I undo a couple more screws here. Oh, there's something I didn't notice earlier. Is that a date code? 2015, 7th month, 19th day for the PCB design? Quite possibly. So, I keep touching the lens. Under this circuit board, what's on the back side? Oh, even more stuff. We have what looks like a couple of boost or buck converters, judging by the inductors there, and some capacitors are right handy nearby them. A couple more inductors there. Okay. Oh, and this side of the board says 2016. So, did they design one side of the silkscreen in 1 year and the other side in a different year? But there you can see the infrared receiver, the SD card holder, all the various connectors. Yeah. What is that system on chip here? It's running the whole thing. MST3M182VGC, blah, 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 blah. Means nothing to me. Does anybody recognize that logo? I don't. Anyway, that's just computer gubbins up there. I'm interested in seeing what makes this happen. Oh, so that looks like a little fan, which makes sense because there was some airflow through this thing. So let's open up that compartment. Now that comes off, yeah. There's a little tiny fan in there. It's a 12 volt fan. So that stays with what we already know about most of the rest of this thing. That flat flex bends and goes into here. That's where the interesting things are going on. Right then. This time, reveal. So what do we have in here? We have a mirror. We have four lenses. Oh, sorry, three lenses. One, two, three. And this one, see if we can get that out without causing it too much distress. This one is an LCD panel. It is a color LCD. And instead of having a backlight behind it, like a normal laptop screen or something, this one, it just transmits right through. So it acts like a piece of film or a slide or any other transparency that you're projecting. So that's how it does that. That's pretty cool. Put that back so it doesn't get into any kind of trouble. And then let's see what these other lenses are. That one looks just like a polarizing filter. Okay. Can you see? I would need another polarizing filter in order to show that doing its polarizing magic. But you've seen the thing at the little test card at sunglasses displays, right? And this one back here, I think, yeah, that's a Fresnel lens. It's a kind of a magnifying lens. They're often, can you see that circular pattern there? There's the pattern that's ground into the glass. And that just acts like a magnifier. Fresnel lenses are cool. Those guys are used in old school spotlights, maybe even some more modern ones. And those cheap plastic magnifiers that are just made out of a thin film of plastic are also often Fresnel lenses. And that's a lens of a different kind. There's one thing that it's doing is it's flipping the image upside down, but that's not surprising for a lens. But it's also another Fresnel lens. Huh. That's kind of cool. And it's plastic. All these lenses are plastic, actually. So those will be used to sort of spread the light out and even the light out a little bit, is my guess. There, it's back in there. And then this is a mirror. It's also a plastic mirror. And it's just set at 45 degrees so that this goes chonk, chonk. Right. So what else have we got? Oh, there's a heat sink there. So this is probably the light source in this little block down here. Take some more screws out. And that looks like it's just holding some things, some wires and stuff in place. There's one screw there. And I assume there is another one right back there, yeah. And now, will that light block come out? There it is. So that's a thermal sensor. And that is an LED cob. Three vertically and two horizontally. Or the other way around when it's set down there. And then it's got this funkadelic little reflector thing here. That just shines all the light out towards this set of lenses. And that one, I don't think I got back in properly. The lens holders are up there, so that's okay. Anyway, yeah, so that just shines a stupid brightness of light out. That scratched a little bit in there, huh? And then we have this thermal cutout. It says 80 degrees Celsius on it over there, which is jammed up against the heat sink. So 80 Celsius, yeah, that's not ridiculously high temperatures that they're worried about. I guess if it's inside a plastic housing, it's never going to get too stupidly hot. There. So that's a curious little guy. What's going on with the lenses here? Should I take a peek at the lens? It's just a lens on a little rotating... Ah, there we go. So that pin is just held on this part of the lens, and as you slide it back and forth, it just does that and pushes the lens further forward and back. Huh. Nothing to that. So that is pretty cool. It's more interesting than some of its parts. I mean, the magic's all happening on this circuit board here, but that's not going to be much different, really, than say one of those digital picture frames, because it's taking various different video sources and it's putting them onto an LCD screen, right? The only real difference is this one's shining an amp or more worth of light out of it and through that and out here. Oh, that was fun to take a look at. It's not earth-shattering technology. It's like a decade and a half out-of-date technology. But it's always kind of fun to see what's going on inside these little things. Now then, a big full-size video projector is not going to be that much different. The light's going to be bigger, obviously. It's still going to have the stack of lenses. It's still going to be shooting through an LCD, probably just larger and obviously a much higher dot pitch. Bouncing off a mirror, maybe. It could also go straight through. There's no reason why it wouldn't, except for space saving. And then the lens. If it wasn't for the only real difference will be that this one is 320 by 100 and whatever it was. And a bigger one, these days especially, will be really 1080 on that LCD. Or 4K or whatever, however many K's or G's or whatever it is that your newfangled stuff has. That was fun. Hope you enjoyed it. I always kind of wondered about these things, and now I know. If you got any questions or comments, down below as usual. I'll talk to you later.